Hi, Angie B here, and I'm standing outside Reading's Hexagon Theatre, where we are soon to see the arrival of the Ballroom Boys. The Ballroom Boys stars the hugely successful Strictly Come Dancing stars Ian Waite and Vincent Simone. I'm about to go and have a quick chat with just one of these celebrities to find out a little bit more about the Ballroom Boys. Hi, Ian Waite. Hello, are you?
I'm very well, thank you. So Ollie's just decided to interrupt our interview.
Oh, it all adds to the entertainment, doesn't it? Hello! Well, thank you so much for giving me your time. You are such a busy guy. I mean, it's really difficult to pin you down because you have so much going on at the moment. But really appreciate a little bit of a quick chat with you before you whiz off somewhere else. But ultimately, I wanted to have a chat to you about your current tour, and that is the Ballroom Boys.
That's right. Yeah, well, the Ballroom Boys was something which my it was kind of like an idea from my dad. Actually, he said to me, why don't you get one of the former pro boys from Strictly and do a show with them. He did actually suggest Matthew Cutler, and I know that Matthew Cutler's not really doing very much at the moment, so I thought Ollie behave. I thought, well, Vincent Simone, he's free, because I knew that Flavia was taking a break. So I called him, and he was on holiday in Spain. And he said, yeah, I'd love to, Bello. Bello, I'd love to. Bello, I would love to. So, he was up for the idea. And I just, that moment, I thought, we're going to call it the Ballroom Boys. And he thought it was a great idea.
Any ideas on, was there any other names that came to the forefront, or was it always going to be the Ballroom Boys?
We could have called it the Legends or...
And when did rehearsals start?
So I actually started quite early on, probably the beginning of April, because I wanted to get all of our solo numbers out of the way. So my numbers with Crystal Main and Vincent got all his solos done as well. So that when we got together, it was just the group numbers. But we started at the beginning of April, and then we went live on the 30th of April.
Okay, so obviously the curtain's gone up and you've gone off on tour. You obviously were sort of primarily responsible for the choreography, the set, the format. What do you think's different about this particular production?
It's different because it has a lot of variety, and also we like to get the audience involved. So, you know, most dance shows that you see are like 2-hour dance shows where you just get dancing, and you just have to sit there and watch the whole 2 hours dancing with a break in the middle. Whereas ours isn't like that. We chat about Strictly, we sing, well, I sing anyway, Vincent doesn't. We get the audience up for audience participation. We do lots of different types of dance, not only ballroom. We do a lot of sort of top hat ballroom, very Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. Really. We do a lot of Rat Pack as well in there. But also you've got your sort of vibrant dances and also dramatic numbers. In amongst that, we've got a lot of chat about Strictly. There's a lot of banter between me and Vince because we are a comedy sort of duo. And when you come and see the show, you'll realise that. It's very much, I mean, even just our height is funny. You know what I mean? He's so much smaller than me. And then we do a really funny number together, which is hilarious. And it's been going down very well.
Oh, that's great. I mean, it sounds like you've really put a lot of thought into putting as much variety as you can in there, something for everyone. Quite different when you say you sing, because most people relate to you as obviously the king of ballroom and to a certain degree the king of presenting, because you're seen on it Strictly, you know, it takes two. So to help sort of how you sing, that must be another thing that your audiences must be quite...
I was trained by the same person. I trained for about 4 or 5 years with the same person that trained Michael Crawford for Phantom. Oh. So Ian Adams. So I have to be honest, I've never actually sang in public until I started doing my own shows. And then I would do sort of like comedy like performances. Like last year, I did Copacabana and I did a little bit of Footloose the year before. And I'm just, you know, at the end of that, I'm not a singer, I'm a dancer. But I like to sing and I like to put it in if possible. Oh, well, let's go for a walk now.
Maybe the bit when you were saying you were singing.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, he doesn't like that too much.
Aww. No, that's great. I mean, obviously you've got a whole variety in there, and just talking about you and Vincent having this comedy banter and this sort of nice double act. I have to say, when I looked on some of the advertising for the show and I saw the two of you and the camaraderie of the both of you, I was thinking a little bit more Come and Wise.
Well, actually, funny you should say that, because we do a tribute to Morecambe and Wise in there, which makes sense, because we have that sort of physical, it's physically funny between the two of us, as I say, but we've got that chemistry, which is very similar. You know, I'm kind of the straight one, and he's the comedy one, or... Yeah, I mean, it depends, because we mix it up. But yeah, you're right. It's very much Morecambe and Wise.
And I actually thought it came across quite naturally done as well when I saw it. Because, you know, sometimes if it's forced or if it's not necessarily, you know, if it's a little bit of a play act. But I actually thought the two of you, and that came across really well, that you've got this lovely rapport.
Yeah, well, we actually, that filming that we did was just at a photo shoot. Mm. And they said, we just want to film a little bit. And what do you want to do? And literally, that was all we did. Mm. We just did 2 minutes of filming, and that's the bit, that's what you saw. There was no editing. That was it.
Yeah.
And yeah, I mean, I think that I can be funny sometimes, but Vince is hilarious. So actually, bouncing off of each other, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's good timing, and it comes across really well. So the show's off. It's touring. All the costumes are in place. The sets are all in place. Coming to Reading on Friday, hometown. How does that feel when you come back to perform in front of your hometown?
Yeah, it's always special, because obviously I've got a lot of people there that I know. All my Fitsteppers, I think about 30 of you. And my father always takes a lot of people from the County School of Dancing. Mm-hmm. I think he's got about 100 people coming. And lots of friends and family come. So yeah, for me it's like a home show. And you know, the thing is, our show is a very intimate show, and we really suit sort of small theatres. So the Hexagon isn't ideal, but it's always a fantastic place to perform, and it's always been very special to me. So I should be there on Friday night, and no doubt having a laugh with the audience, and hopefully they love it. I mean, it's you know, it takes a year to produce and put together.
Yeah.
I mean, I started this like last May, so I've spent all that year preparing. And sometimes you think, oh God, how am I going to make it better than the year before? And am I going to be able to think of the funny things? And are we able to going to be able to do amazing performances? I mean, fortunately, we've got some gorgeous girls dancing with us, Crystal Main and Ksenia Hotska, who are partnering us. And we've got an amazing singer as well, who was one of the first Billy Elliots in the West End. So
great!
He's amazing. He opens up the show with a tap number, top hat, and it's really special. And he's a special performer. He lives it, breathes it, and you can see that in his performances.
Yeah, that's really good for you to have those people on board. And I think for people like ourselves who live local, to see you perform in your hometown, I mean, you've had such an extensive, successful career. You've done so much. So it's almost like, you know, we're all proud when we come along and watch you, because it's like, yes, he's, you know, he's our guy from our area. You know, it's lovely. Come on. Funny moments. Has there been any bloopers or any funny things that have happened so far while you've been on tour?
I'm sure there's quite a few, but I mean we've had, because of this audience participation, it's always different every night. And we did get a little boy up in Ireland, and he said that he was a dancer, but he'd only been dancing 8 weeks. And we dressed him up, and then he performed, and he absolutely... everybody went absolutely wild, because he was so brilliant. Has anything else gone wrong that's been funny? It's difficult, you know, because it's such a...
Because, you know, sometimes you never know, and because it's a live show, sometimes you don't know, you know, how audiences are going to react. Some get really excitable, some want to be up there joining in with you. So I just wondered if there was anything that stood out in your mind from the way that the audiences have been reacting.
Well, last year I had a funny moment where my microphone went down. So I had to take somebody else's hand mic, and it was actually our singer at the time. So I took the singer's hand mic and I'd finished speaking, and then I went off the wrong side and she was coming on the other side. So I had to run across the front of the stage to give her the microphone, because obviously my microphone had gone down, which was hilarious, like me running across the stage to give her this microphone before this really dramatic rumba, a beautiful number. But I can't think of that. There must be something which has been hilarious. But that's the great thing about this show. It's not too serious, and there's a lot of ad lib in there. So it always changes every night, which keeps it fresh. You know, it keeps us excited to perform it.
Absolutely, and that's the difference, isn't it, between a theatre performance and say, for example, television. You have a different kind of experience, don't you? You have a big audience, and you have to work spontaneously, don't you, with whatever's thrown at you.
And we do get hecklers, and so I'm like always like,
and that's just your fit steppers.
I know, I'm trying to heckle back, you know. And sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but I'm not as good as Jimmy Carr, unfortunately.
Thank goodness not. Well, I mean, we're all really excited to see you on Friday, but naturally what we'll do is continue to support the rest of the tour, and, you know, all the very best with that.
Thank you.
And the success of your Footsteps dancing brand that you're spreading all over the UK, which constantly keeps popping up on social media. I don't know how you fit all of this in. I don't know, all the very best with the rest of the tour. Thanks so much for taking some time to chat to me. Just as a little finish off, shall we go and have a little fun and do some footsteps just to finish off before you go off? Actually, last question. Favorite musical? Have you got a favorite musical?
Favorite musical. God, what have I seen the most? Because I love so many. I love Wicked, and I love Phantom of the Opera.
Diverse.
So many. I mean, I've seen Chicago 100 times.
The list goes on, doesn't it? It's very difficult to choose, isn't it, when someone says, "What's your favourite show?" Because we are so lucky, aren't we?
I went to see Aladdin recently in New York. And that was sensational. The leads were just like awesome.
Yeah, it's a great show, isn't it? But it's really hard to choose just one, isn't it, when we're spoilt for choice. Anyway, thank you so much. Let's go and have a little bit of fun and do some footsteps, shall we? Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Right, Angie, let's do some footsteps.
Okay, yeah.
Let's do some dirty dancing, shall we? Yes. Let's go.